Please be seated. We have come together today to celebrate the marriage of Maxine and Patrick. No one should enter into marriage lightly, but reverently in the sight of Almighty God. So it falls to me to ask, if anyone knows a reason why these persons should not lawfully marry, then please declare it now. Patrick Charles Blake, will you take Maxine Stephanie Miniver to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Maxine Stephanie Miniver, will you take Patrick Charles Blake to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Maxine, is everything okay?
Everything will be different once we're married, I promised you.
I will.
Maxine Blake. Got a good ring to it, doesn't it?
The best.
Oh, Mark. Listen, we both wanted to say a big thank you. Not only for today, but also for yesterday. This wedding may never have happened if it weren't for you.
Oh, I was the best man for it.
Patrick, can I have a word?
Yeah.
It seems the budget for the vino might have been a bit meano, if you catch my drift.
Okay. Well, excuse me, Mrs. Blake. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Weird, isn't it?
What's weird?
Getting married. I mean, that's what you dreamed of when you were a girl. An uptight head teacher with issues.
I dreamt of a man who loved me. And Patrick does more than you will ever understand. Thank you.
Oh, really, I'm the one you should be congratulating for winning myself such a perfect bride. And I'm going to do my best to deserve her and to live up to the promises I've made.
You guys.
It's good. Go on.
No, thank you. I'm all right.
You're ridiculous. Sharing our first piece of wedding cake. Here. Maxine? You're really going to ruin this perfect moment. Come on. Stop being stupid and eat.
Everyone, excuse me, yes, me again. My next duty as best man is to introduce truly the best man of the day, Patrick Blake. Yay! He's done so much for this community, for his students, for his family, and for his beautiful new wife. Now I'm getting all the warm words out of the way now because my best man speech is going to be more brutal than your end of term report for Robert Oscar. Please, everyone, give it up for the man of the hour, Patrick Blake. Oh, wait, please, sorry, just before I forget, before I've had too much to drink to remember, can we thank all the staff here at the job?
You cannot humiliate me like this.
I can't stay.
If you walk out of here now, then we'll take you home and show you the error of your ways.
Patrick, please, the baby.
You should have thought of the baby before trying to make a fool of me. Is everyone up?
I am sorry, but, fortunately Maxine's not feeling very well, so I'm afraid I'm going to have to escort her home.
Come on.
I can go on my own.
Maxine, insist.
No.
Come on, sweetheart, he's your husband now. He just wants to do the right thing.
Exactly. I can't let you live on your own, can I?
I said I was fine.
I said I...
Maxine.
Sweetheart, what's happened?
It's Patrick. Patrick beats me.
Thank you.